so many times, trying to keep my head high while everybody's dancing. Cause I know I'm not the only one. I know I'm not the only one. Since you took gold on my broken heart, just like a miracle.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the last RSC 12 League Play stream. My name is Jasper, and joined with me today is the wonderful Sir Pegasus. How are you doing today?
I'm doing absolutely beautiful. RLCS is on, but do you know what's important? This RSC Week 9, we got a prospect match. Tomfoolery versus Fearless Echo as they fight for a playing position.
This spot means everything to both the teams, I am sure. Tomfoolery versus Fearless Echo. Definitely going to be an interesting game. But coming up later today at the 9 p.m. CEST slot, we've got Mischief versus Shrine. Definitely going to be a close game there, I imagine. 9th versus 4th doesn't really have odds for anything. And then coming into 22 CEST, Mosaic versus Tartarus. Another prospect game which should hopefully have some exciting odds, as that can secure a playoff spot potentially. No, I'm wrong. No playoff spot can be guaranteed, but a win for Mosaic could make a difference here. Looking at team stats, Pegasus, take us away. What do you see?
So obviously you got the close to equal wins, a two difference in the score, which actually is quite an interesting dynamic for this game, because if Fearless Echo, second place, win 3-1 and gets equal game wins, they make it by game differential. As Tomfoolery lost to Fearless Echo 4-0. So today's all about revenge.
Ooh, a revenge game indeed is what I love to watch, is what I love to see. As we've got some love in the chat for Illusory right now, GM Rahu's definitely going to be looking out for this one, because a draw secures play-ins, as we've said. Looking at player stats though, I'm going to be looking at Deadeye, Matt Blue and Morikonda here. Morikonda, someone that I know is a very good player, been here for a long time, has won a tier previously, you know, 44 goals, 63 saves, you know, this team looks unstoppable. What do you see on the other side of Echo?
TX, 52 games, 46 goals, and 28 assists. I mean, that is incredible. Maybe not as good as your Deadeye or Matt Blue on the other side, but still enough to make the difference. And Captain Boyo, 48 games, 35 goals. Another person who can really make a difference.
Yeah, definitely. It's very exciting to see, and it's going to keep us close as we take a look at the prospect standings for Glacies. Now, having a look, Tomfoolery, Echo, a draw secures play-ins, and if Echo can pull out a 3-1, then they secure themselves a play-in spot. It's all to play for as the last game of the Glacies Conference, if I am... Yep, last game. And Pegasus is everything to play for, but I'm going to ask you the most important question of this game, arguably. Who do you think is going to win?
Tomfoolery are here for revenge. They want to shut out Delta, and I think they will do it.
Ooh.
So, 3-1. 3-1. Not a sweep, but 3-1.
Very interesting indeed. But myself, I'm going to go for a 2-2 draw for Tomfoolery, just to barely inch out that play-in spot. I have no fear that they'll be able to do that, because, you know, both of these teams are pretty good, and hopefully that's what we'll see.
Yes, absolutely. I'd like to quickly apologise. I said Delta, I meant Echo. I'm a Challenger player. I'm used to seeing that badge and thinking of a different name. But let's get into the lobby and let's get this grudge match started. Tomfoolery versus Fearless Echo.
3, 2, 1, and the timer starts ticking now. Kick off, the most important thing, and it's gone Echo's way. We've got Detach on the ball, trying to fake out a reset, but Matt Blue, no surprise to that. Definitely going quickly now. Boyo going for the back wall. That name is blurred out for me. I cannot see that name.
Okay, early back to TX.
Thank you very much. But we're seeing some early aggression here from Echo. definitely coming out of the gate swinging with no fear. TX now on the ball. Ball bounces, but that's going to be Deadeye. Deadeye now to Matt Blue, but there's going to be TX again. Now Boyo going off the sidewall, and Pegasus, arguably, you know, the pressure that Echo is putting up, all three players seem to be just forward. Do you think this could end quite badly for them?
As we know, one of the most scariest things in Rocket League is the counter-attack, but it's also the attack! Coming up off the floor, some mechanics, a double tap to open the series.
What a double tap! And if I'm not mistaken, Detach definitely going to be a key player of this series and one to watch coming into play-ins. Swinging out the gate, and now Detach, a lovely kickoff. And it's now going to be Matt Blue trying to push that ball forward. Doesn't come to line. Matt Blue now. Matt Blue to the middle, but Detach is there. DX now, but Morikonda to the middle. Nobody's there to be able to put the pressure. Matt Blue getting outplayed by Detach. What are we going to see? Boyo with no boost, having to take a 50 to the sidewall. Now it's TX on the ball. TX 50 with Morikonda here. That ball goes to no man's land, but it's going to be Detach to pick this up. Detach now not being able to get much, and it's going to be Deadeye. Deadeye going for a shot. Not coming to light. No clinicality there. TX just trying to keep that ball forward, trying to keep that pressure up. And Pegasus is just so interesting right now. We're seeing the opposite of what the leaderboard's suggesting with current standings, you know. And it's going to be very, very interesting on who is going to come out on top.
On that first, after that first goal, it feels like tomfoolery. I've put my foot on the accelerator. More of this game, instead of being in their half, has been stuck in the midfield. A very aerial game so far. And just as I say that, we get a ground shot. An open net. He's just faster.
Yeah, definitely a lovely touch from Boyo there. Just nobody in the defense. Morikonda just caught out of position. And that's TX for the take in it, as we see them go 2-0 up now. Just looking in the chat, we see such a split between the players. It's all 50-50 right now. You know, half the people here definitely coming out for Echo. You got Buddha and Buddha, the CEO of Fearless, and the GM, swinging his love there for the players. That's Morikonda, lovely touch. Morikonda for a simple touch, but Detach, lovely shot to the back wall, waterfalling down now. Matt Blue getting demoed, that's two demos. This could be a goal, and it's now Deadeye to keep them on the board and keep them lurking.
Deadeye keeping the boogeyman away. They got swept last time they played Echo, but he's opening up the scoring to try and shut the gap and maybe get some game wins back against this team. Kickoff in favor of Tomfoolery. Still looking to find their equalizer. If they don't score again, game over. They need to be on the attack.
100%. All they need is a couple more counterattacks, and they can see themselves right back in the shoes of this game. As TX now to the middle, nobody's going to be there. It's going to be Matt Blue to get a touch. Now seeing Deadeye, a bump from Matt Blue to the middle. Morikonda not jumping, playing it safe as the third person in the lobby. Morikonda getting 50'd out by TX. That's going to be Boyo. Boyo to the middle, Matt Blue to Deadeye, Matt Blue back up in the air, but TX is there. Now going to be Morikonda, she's on the back foot here, getting a nice touch. Not going to come to light, as Morikonda now driving that ball forward, getting demo chase and gets demoed. That's all three demos out, and demos are going crazy right now, Pegasus, right?
I mean, but like we said before, this is a grudge match, and that's when the demos come out, and that one has given them a goal. Four demos within the last minute. But the most important one there on Deadeye, giving them the goal and the two goal cushion.
100%. You know, it's just great to see a cushion goal now into play. Echo are going to come for the upset right now. Definitely going to want to try and take our predictions away, it seems. Pegasus.
Hey, I predicted 3-1. There's still a chance. There is still very much a chance. I mean, Tomfoolery, they're learning how they play. They might come in, the captain can give a team talk, and they can come back a different team.
Hopefully so. I mean, they definitely need to come out as a different team if they want to be in the play-ins, because we know how intense play-ins and playoffs are. And, you know, if they just scrape it, playing how they're playing now, I wouldn't see them going really far into that bracket. What do you think, though?
Listen, playoffs, it's a different kind of pressure. Teams play differently when they're there. This game, I think, is all about confidence. That big margin, that is all that it's for leading into playoffs. And just as we say that, there's an attack quickly stopped. Farshan Matlu manages to force it through the keeper. That's all in the power.
You know, just that pressure, just that counter, and it's just enough. Matt Blue definitely wanting to be that one to keep the hopes alive. 22 seconds, we know anything can happen. A good kickoff could see it, but that's a hard cheat there from TX. Boyo instantly up, and that's TX trying to go for a shot. Not happening. Matt Blue getting, could have got a 50 there to secure a goal. Not happening. That's detached now. Detached to TX. TX to the backboard. Boyo jumping, but Matt Blue there. Matt Blue to Morikonda. Morikonda with a shot. Detached with a save. 1 second left. Deadeye's up. Deadeye with a shot. And it's Matt Blue. 0 seconds. What a goal to equalize with 0 seconds now.
And you can't ask for anything better. Matt Blue using TX. A soft ground to make sure that they get this overtime. Oh, the game feels like it's getting closer and closer. Fearless Echo have game prepped up on leading into this overtime. A confidence killer, but Echo aren't feeling it. 4-3, they take game one.
What a game and what a fake from Detach. They're absolutely rattling their opponents. And that's now Boyo to secure the goal. To secure game one. First game is always one of the most important, I think, because, you know, really sets off the tone and really sets off how they are going to play. But Pegasus, take us through the scoreboard.
Sorry, my screen currently has blacked out. So if you could take over.
Of course. Just having a look. Echo, TX, 2 goals, 2 saves, 1 assist, a key player there. Getting all the aggression, all players of Echo, by the way, all of her 500 points really shows that there is not one carry, but a group effort there from that team. And Tom Follery, they've got Matt Blue, who's, you know, 532 points, definitely being the driving force of the first man offense. While you see Morikonda, while she's on the lowest points, she is just the backbone structure of that defense, getting the most saves on the team and just keeping it in. And this game just is going to be intense. You're definitely one of those grudge matches, like you've said, and getting ready to get into game two now.
Morikonda, the only player on the pitch not to score, but still had 4 shots. That pressure is so vital, especially in this tier where mistakes can happen. And both teams, I feel like, have been cleaning up pretty well.
Yeah, definitely. It's just like, as soon as you see one attack come through, another one, or another attack or a counterplay just comes out, and it's just showing how diverse and how Prospect is such an unpredictable tier. As we see the kickoff, Matt Blue now just winning it out, but this is TX. TX going for a double touch. Oh my! TX with a beautiful double touch. Wow!
Well, TX was the person who got scored on in 0 seconds. But now, 6 seconds into the next game, starts the scoring. You can try and dunk on TX. TX will dunk on you.
That was beautiful. Boyo getting a flip reset to just drive it past. That's a double commit, though. Could be dangerous. Matt Blue now having to take that corner. Going for a ceiling shot. Risque, you could say. That's Deadeye getting a whiff. Now Morikonda. Morikonda to the side, but that's Boyo to interfere. Deadeye up to Matt Blue. Matt Blue onto the backboard. Will we see Deadeye go? We see Deadeye go, and Deadeye, Matt Blue. The passing play comes back out, and it's now equaled up.
Matt Blue sees that unguarded backboard and just makes sure to take advantage. Trust in your teammate. That's what that goal was about. And they are equal to scoring.
Indeed, equal scoring, and Pegasus is such an important game. you know, I'm just watching such heavy action, and that's off the goal line. Boy, I didn't even get to ask my question. Pegasus, who do you think's going to win this game?
Listen, Echo, I feel it is the safe pick right now, but Tomfoolery, I feel like they're just building up. If you want my honest opinion, I think this might go down to a draw.
I mean, I love the sound of that, you know, that's my prediction, Pegasus.
Yeah, well, my predictions have not been great recently. And Fearless Echo, in another attack, trying to ruin it even more. And no one's there to clean up, and TX misses what could have been a very important touch. He did have a teammate waiting in the midfield. Matt Blue, ready on the counter. Deadeye pre-jumps. And Marikonda, always ready to be the third man, always ready to clean up and keep these attacks going, but it's quickly shot by TX, who I just feel like has been everywhere this series.
Yeah, definitely. TX has just been doing a bit of everything, and that's a shot on the back lines. Boyo getting there. Marikonda, she's just out for blood now. She wants that goal. She wants to prove that just being a third person is not, that's just not her role, and she wants to get a goal, but just not happening yet. Deadeye now, Deadeye getting it down the field. Now Boyo on ball, Deadeye again, Deadeye pre-jumping. And that's now Matt Blue trying to get a touch, not happening. Marikonda sweeping forward now to the middle. Nobody's there though. Somebody needs to be there to clean those up, to get shots off. But Deadeye now, Deadeye bringing that pressure right back. That's to the middle. Somebody, anybody should be going for that. It just doesn't happen. That ball goes right back to middle there. And it's just not gone their way as pressure is flipped.
Tomfoolery, they've had the chances. This really feels like they shouldn't be their game to lose. And that's another attack stopped by Deadeye, who looks to start one of his own. And, oh my god, it's just back and forth. As soon as I try to call one attack, it switched right back onto the other team.
Definitely, definitely such an unpredictable match right now. Can't really say for sure who's going to come out on top, but all I know is I'm here for whatever happens, and that's Deadeye driving that ball forward, trying to get anything, any clutches of a goal. Now Matt Blue on the ceiling gets it taken right past from TX. TX to Detach. TX misses Detach with a shot. It's now TX. TX trying to get it to the middle. Boyo doesn't go. Boyo conserving boost and playing it safe. Now as that ball gets left to no man's land, and it's Marikonda going under. No boost, can't really go for that ball. So leaves it to Matt Blue, and it's now Marikonda. Marikonda hits it to the back ball, but that's Detach. Detach, unfortunate touch behind. And that's now Deadeye. Deadeye with a shot. Boyo and TX double commit, and that could be a goal. Boyo with a save.
Boyo, another player who I just think is one to watch. Echo, every player feels like they are doing a job. Boyo, very active in the midfield, and Marikonda's in the attack. Detach, looking to start the attack now. Deadeye stops it. TX can Detach clean it up. No, it's just straight in. And just like I said before, every single person on this team, it feels like they're doing a job. Detach got the assist and was ready to clean up if there was a goalkeeper on the line, but TX had so many touches this game. Two goals from two shots, clinical.
Definitely one of the more clinical plays right now. 100% goal shot percentage. That's really good to see. Can really boost stats as well if you're a stats person. If you're doing the stats mini game. I can't remember what it's called. maybe a player to look out for. And right now, such a short amount of time, and I don't know who is going to come back now. Tomfoolery, just, they need to get something. They need anything. That's not what they need, though, as Boyo gets a fourth on the board. Three shots and two goals, and it's looking over for Tomfoolery.
I think you're the captain of this team. You already start conversations of what you're going to change leading into the next game. This looks unsavable. Play your best. Try and build some momentum. Just think what next.
Just think what next indeed. Look forward, look to the next couple games, because it's going to be a long climb ahead. That's Marikonda now driving that ball down the field. Detach trying to go for a little bit of a double touch to keep that ball out of his half. doesn't come to light. TX now, TX to Boyo. Boyo taking it quite close, and that's a bomb, but Morikonda, the savior, will be there. Matt Blue to Morikonda. Morikonda, she's driving that ball up the field. Detach. That's a bump. That's a demo. That could be a goal, but Deadeye just is not there. And the game goes to Echo's side. 2-0 to Echo now.
Yeah, I mean, that's halftime in the series. 2-0. Echo just seem to be the boogeyman for this team. Revenge has been given. They want to steal this play-in spot, and they very much look like they will get it. I believe one more win and they to steal the spot. Sunday, week 9. This is as late as it could happen. This is heartbreaking for tomfoolery. How do you save this?
I mean, I honestly don't know how you save it, because, you know, even if it's 3-1, it goes to head-to-head, and looking back, I don't know who won the original playoff between the two teams. Because it was 4-0 to Echo, if I'm correct, right?
Yes.
That means that they will win on head-to-head, because Echo have got their first game in hand as well. So tomfoolery are really do or die now. They need the next two games, and Fearless, they need to hold on. Tomfoolery need to change something up. If I was them, I would be calling a timeout right now, because timeouts are available on RSC. You can call a 2-minute timeout, if I'm correct in saying, and really, that's what I would be doing, because this game is do or die for Tomfoolery. As we see the kickoff start, TX now, TX taking it slowly in air, TX, TX! Oh my word, TX nearly gets the beautifulest double.
And he did it in the last game as well, within the first few seconds, took possession of the ball, went high, got a double touch, and you know, I think that just shows the quality we have here in RSC. This is a mid-table game in the lowest division, and we're still seeing those high mechanical plays. It's truly impressive and just shows how much RSC has to offer.
Yeah, definitely. That is the truest thing I've ever heard. And right now, Matt Blue getting a demo. Matt Blue can get a touch to the middle, does so, but gets pinched away. Now Morikonda on the back foot, pedaling back slowly. Morikonda now just trying to stay on that wall, see if a pass could go through. That's Deadeye now, but Detach, no stranger to those touches. Boyo, what a lovely, lovely touch. That ball gets cleared out now. That's TX up, TX down to Morikonda. Boyo now taking control of this ball, going for a flick, but gets demoed by Morikonda. And this is in no man's land again. And that's TX, a lovely rivalry. One of the best prospect players I've ever seen touch this tier. That could be Morikonda with an open net. And Morikonda starts Tomfoolery's engines off and gets the first goal.
Slow in the last game, but we can see there's a clear difference heading into this one. Just way more active on the pitch. And maybe this is the start Tomfoolery needed. Morikonda to take the reins and throw this into a draw. And I think you're right about TX. Goes for another mechanical play. Listen, I'm challenger tier, Jasper. I hope TX isn't coming up to my tier, because that is someone to be feared. A low CMB. Very, very nice. I think end up being an underrated player. TX again finds himself in the air and detach. I think this is one thing that Echo have done a lot better than Tomfoolery. The second man has just always been ready. I feel like they've had the good touches, but no one's there to finish the job and clean it up. And just again, Boyo, the second man to keep the attack alive. It's just, it seems like the same old story.
Yeah, 100%, I see what you mean. But you know, we say this, but for Tomfoolery, they seem to just be out of position a lot, and as soon as I say that, they're out of position, and Detach and Boyo can just link up to get a free goal.
This is really well played from Boyo. As soon as they know they got their touch, immediately charging for the goalkeeper. Many people there would turn, try to go to the third man. No, when you're still involved in the attack, stay involved in the attack. And that, I think, has been the reason they have won the last two games.
Yeah, Yeah, definitely, 100%. Oh my god, Deadeye fakes one and nearly gets the shot. That just doesn't come to light. That's TX, what a low touch! And Morikonda has to clear it off the line, does so, but TX is there. TX gets a reset, gets a flick, and that's Boyo diving in irresponsibly. That second man we say was always ready in that time. Second man just irresponsibly dives, and this is Deadeye now. Deadeye, what a shot! And Tomfoolery are back in the lead. They know they need this game more than anyone right now. They are doing so.
That speed, that's accuracy. No one in net to clean the shot, but if there was someone, I think that steal would have found its way in. Nice and clean, bottom left corner. Can they get their first win? They lose this kickoff, but Deadeye did so well to hit the ball last time. Doesn't this time, it's a 50 in the midfield. It's in Phyllis Echo's favor, and TX, I mean, someone get out his RL tracker. I'm not sure if he's meant to be in this tier.
Well, we do see a season 10 GC, but you know, last season was a very inflated season, not taking anything away from TX. A very good player, and certainly one to watch, but it does seem a Boyo when misses the ball, TX was just there, and it does really reinforce your point of the fact that they always have a second man available. And it sometimes really does show that it works out, because like, look at that. Detached to read Boyo's little clearance back, and Deadeye now. TX is going to keep on going for that ball. Demo comes out, Matt Blue getting a demo, trying to make some any space, and that's TX. Wow, what a read, and TX is really, really trying to keep this game in afloat for the TX. Somebody clip this man. Somebody put him on the clip of the week. Please, what a double touch I've just seen.
I just can't even believe what I'm watching. First game of the day, chat, and you have been in for a treat. You thought, you know, we'll warm ourselves up. Prospect game, they're fighting for players. And we're seeing mechanics, TX. It's not only the goals they've been scoring. We've seen the odd attempt at a flip reset. We've seen the odd attempt at a ceiling shot. I mean, the showmanship is beautiful and it's fearless, the touch. This team is amazing. How are they only seventh place?
Couple of bad weeks can do that though. You know, when you have issues with surfacing a full team, you know, teams can sometimes go, and you know, it just goes to show that you never underestimate who's where. And now you just see TX clearing off the backboard. Lovely double touch, Boyo now. Boyo clearing it. And it's now just Matt Blue, and it's just a deadlock of a game, and it's an amazing, amazing game at that. I'm loving watching this. I'm Boyo now. Detached, keeping it up, and honestly, I'm so shocked at this. TX is better than me. That's what I'm saying.
I just feel like Echo really do play for each other. As much as they go for this individual play, they always have someone waiting to save the day if there's a save or there's a whiff, which can happen in this tier, obviously. Or if they are the first man, they lose the ball, they're instantly going for the bump to make the job easier for the second man. I think that's just something Tomfoolery don't have. They don't feel like they've got that same level of chemistry as this Echo side have. And the pressure has been on for Echo, and leading into play-ins where pressure is at this highest, I think they'll be all right.
Yeah. I definitely agree. Definitely. And now East Fearless has secured play-ins now. 3-0, they've secured it.
And now I'd like to say who would have seen this coming, but they did sweep this team last time. Sometimes it's not all about the table, it's about the head-to-head, and that's why that rule is in place.
I mean, yeah, but the head-to-head is over, because Echo have already won their first game against them. It's just over at that point in time. And I mean, 3-1, because still you've got the correct spot on your prediction, but just the wrong teams. So hopefully we, it's just a shame, because Tomfoolery coming into this, they probably had a lot of hope for getting into a playing spot, and it just comes to see that Echo have just completely demolished Tom Foolery.
Sadly, I was put in this position this week, Jasper, heading into game four, knowing that my chances for play-ins were non-existent. You just do your final hurrah, you try and play your best, and get the best finish you can.
I mean, we still have one more game, you know. Fun to play, and we see Matt Blue driving that ball forward now. Detach getting it off the crossbar. Morikonda now. Morikonda to Deadeye. That's a shot just going slightly wide. And now Boyo with a wide, wide clear. Now it's just no man's land once more. TX to the middle. TX now not getting a shot off. TX definitely could have had that shot and had that goal. Detach now trying to go for another shot. And Boyo missing the ball. Matt Blue having a field day. Pinch attempt doesn't come to light, unfortunately. And Pegasus already. It's just so back and forth again.
And Echo, you can tell they've not put their foot on the brake. They want the coveted 8-0, which not many people can say they can get. I mean, isn't that exciting? 8-0. What do you do?
Definitely. What a fake! And what a goal! Morikonda just booms it, and a lovely fake comes out from Matt Blue, and it's just in the net.
Morikonda had a slower start in the first two games, but definitely showed themselves a lot more in the last one. And I mean, we're only a minute into this one, and it's a goal. You never know. Maybe you can beat them seven times. How about not eight? Tom Foolery looking to play this game. Maybe, just for some bragging rights.
I mean, if I was them, I would want to lose, because imagine getting Brazilian league play, you know.
Jasper, but there's just no winning, Jasper.
No winning indeed. Very unfortunate right now. And Detach, keeping that ball forward. Detach again, driving that ball straight forward. And just trying to keep that ball up. That's now TX straight up. Detach just her jump, and that's Detach now. Detach, will we see a double? No, we won't. Just Matt Blue and Morikonda going for a double commit to get that ball out. And now Deadeye keeping that ball away. Deadeye taking it slow up the wall, getting a nice clear away. Detach, lovely save on the ball, and such only half the game through, and it's just looking over while we talk. You know, it's so demotivating to be in the position of, you know, knowing you don't have play-ins, but they're still putting the best fight I've seen this series so far up. 1-0 up, and this is the lowest scoring game we've had so far. As soon as I say that, TX scores. Right, thanks TX.
Jasper, I don't mean to disappoint you, but this goal comes from a counter-attack where Tom Foolery got a double bump on the goal line, an open shot, and then I believe Morikonda missed a completely open net. I mean, it's just devastating. And Boyo, oh, they're just taking no mercy. No mercy, Jasper.
Well, I mean, mercy's the best way to do it, I'd say. Don't show mercy to your enemies.
And I can tell you, they definitely are enemies at this point. Fearless Echo. I hate to say it again and again, but it's what this game has come to. That game difference of 8-0 that Echo are going for. I wonder if they scrim each other.
I mean, they would be good scrim opponents, Echo. I mean, they are doing so great. They are just unstoppable. And that's Boyo getting a reset, but Matt Blue is there to clean up. And it's another demo. The grudge is so alive. Morikonda now takes it against the wall, draws Detach in to just lure him out. Matt Blue, lovely clear away. That's Morikonda. No, it's Matt Blue with the goal.
And this is something we have not seen very often from Fearless Echo. It's been a mistake on the goal line. Detach, don't think he was able to get back in time either way. 2-1, Tomfoolery looking to get this game back. And obviously, we don't want to be biased here as casters, but Echo, they've got everything already. Let them have this win. Deadeye making it 3-1. Hopefully stopping the bleeding just a little bit. Maybe putting on a plaster, let's just say. A plaster and a gun wound.
Hydrogen bomb versus Coughing Baby is what I'm watching right now. I think I said this last time as well.
They're going to watch this back. They're going to watch this back. And their enemies. And they're going to add you to the enemy list.
No. I'm loved by RSC. They would never add me to the enemies list. I'm just a caster doing what a caster does. Staring the part, Morikonda. Lovely shot. Detach now on ball. Detach demoing. That's so rude in TX. Second man is there to follow up. And dare I say it, they want to come back.
TX looking to try and take this into overtime. One more goal needed, and I hate to say it, but it is very much possible with the way that Echo play. So attacking, always have each other's back. I mean, I think that's why they're taking this win. You can tell they're three players that have trained so much together. Even when they double commit, someone will go away from it. They listen to each other in comms. It's just such good Rocket League for this division. It really, really is.
I mean, 100%. And just remember, this is Prospect. The teamwork they have at the lowest tier is incredible. And it only scares me for what we might see in the higher tiers later on. But, you know, 10 seconds left. Are we going to see a fearless goal? Are we going to see an overtime? Pegasus.
They're looking to make it happen. The ball stays up. There's still very much a chance. TX, you don't want to let have access to the back wall. And it's over. Tomfoolery get the, dare I say it, pity win. They're knocked out of RSC this season. GG's Tomfoolery for RSC 12. You put up a decent fight today, but Echo, they just appear to be your boogeyman.
Yeah, Echo. Dominant show. Nearly doubling the boost consumption, 60% field domination almost. And that was amazing. And all I can say is our predictions were wrong, but in vain. We all knew what was happening. Very, very, very unfortunate. And, you know, it was a great series. Mischief, though. They're next. We have another game on next. We have Mischief versus Shrine. And as I said last season, Shrine will shine. They had a very, very miracle run through their bracket last season. And hopefully, well, I mean, I'm not going to give a prediction because I'm not casting. But I'm very excited for what's about to come up next.
I won't make a prediction. I won't make enemies. But quickly, instead of making enemies, let's spread some love. I think TX played amazing that game. I want it to be said on stream. That is so much higher quality than I ever expected being here on a Prospects stream. I mean, I believe two double touches, so much domination in the midfield. You saw flip reset attempts, and that being said, it's hard to be the MVP in that team where your two teammates were playing almost just as well.
I mean, it was an amazing series, and, you know, TX definitely shone through the lights, shone through it all. Because, you know, them double touches is crazy. And that was insane. That was incredible. What a show. But guys, do not go anywhere. Because in 15 minutes, we have Mischief versus Shrine in the Challenger tier. And a titan of a matchup, I would say. And I'm very excited to watch it from the comfort of my chair, because I am not casting next. Just gonna take a look who is casting next, actually. Sir Win-A-Lot and Maurice Sky. Beautiful people indeed, and beautiful to cast with. But people, thank you for coming to watch the game. 44 viewers, that is incredible.
Wow.
Thank you for coming out of your time, even when RLCS is on, you know, 44 viewers, amazing. Much love to you all, but unless you've got anything else to say, Pegasus, we will see you another time.
Goodbye.
Visions of you. Oh,
man, you need some headphones, bro.
you are my lucky charm. I hold you close in the night in my arms. And when we open our eyes, my worries fade away. 'Cause you gave me your heart in the light of day. In the light of day. When we open our eyes, my voice fade away. 'Cause you gave me your heart in the light of day, in the light of day.
Like a psychopathic lunatic. I will park my nine.
Welcome back, everyone. There's been a change in the booth, and just like that, by magic, thank you so much to Jesper and to Sir Pegasus. But they've been replaced by myself, Maurice Sky, and joining alongside me to take us into the second game of this Sunday evening. It's the legend himself. It's been a while, but we're finally casting together win a lot. How are you doing today, buddy?
I've had dreams about this moment. I've been... Well, I didn't sleep much last night, not much dreams there, but we are here and we're ready, and I've been keeping an eye on these series here, and there's been some good Rocket League, and I'm so happy to be back here in the booth with you, Sky.
Oh, mate, it's been a while, but we're going to try and bring the hype for you tonight, because coming up for you, we have Mischiefs versus Shrine in the Challenger Division. You might have just seen Illusionary's prospect team, Tom Foolery, full foul to a 3-1 defeat by Fearless Echo. So it's the turn now of Mischiefs to try and bring back some pride to the Illusionary team. But will they do it? I don't know. On paper, this one, Winlock, is kind of a done and dusted deal. Shrine are currently sitting down ninth in the league, and Mischiefs are sitting there at fourth. And on paper, I think it is pretty much near impossible for Shrine to basically bring themselves back into playoff contention. There's probably like a 1% chance if they come away with a clean sweep and get a ton of goals in. But I don't know about you, Winner. Like, this one seems like it's an uphill struggle, though, for Shrine to get anything out of this game.
Well, they're going to have to run if they're running uphill here. It's going to have to be a full-on sprint. There's going to be no time to pace themselves here. They're going to come in hard, and they're going to have to come in heavy. But this is why we love Rocket League. Some crazy things happen. This is why we don't FF. And we all know this as fans of the sport. Anything can happen when that countdown ends at zero. So I cannot wait for these guys to get going. And there's a lot of stats that we can look at here. But you're right. On paper, it is not looking pretty.
It's not, but I tell you what, I know these guys over at good old Sanctuary, my home team, they will be looking to cause a bit of an upset here. I know in particular Shake and Simdog, they'll be wanting to prove themselves here on stream, because Mischief sitting in at fourth place, they've got a shot potentially of hitting the second spot there in the table, and if they get a good result on this one, then that could sort of make it a little bit easier for their playoff run-in. But certainly, I mean, Shrine, they've got nothing to lose, so this is going to be potentially a chance for them just to come in, play their own game, and just absolutely annoy the heck out of Mischief. And with that in mind, I mean, trust me, deep down, I want to give the underdog in Shrine here. I want to predict and say that they will cause this upset. But I'm sorry, I just can't do it. And prediction-wise, I've gone 3-1. And I think you've got a similar gut feeling to me as well.
Yeah, I'm going to take you 3-1 on it with you as well. And it's not to do with anything else besides I love to create a story. And if we're both wrong, what a story it's going to be. But you're right, there is some points up for grabs here, but the most dangerous team is always the one with nothing left to lose. You got to be careful with those teams. They can just start peeking on you, and you got to be careful the whole way. But we have a sellout crowd here tonight. 444,000 people in attendance, fully sold out, even with RLCS doing their thing. And I got to say, I'm excited.
I am as well. I was trying to avoid mentioning the other Rocket League Championship that was going on.
Yes,
nobody really
yes.
cares about that.
No,
nobody cares
no.
about that. This is where the action is happening over at RSC, and we're heading over to Manfield Knight. And without further ado, we will tell the players to get underway, and we will see whether Shrine can bring their A game finally. I mean, they haven't brought it this season. That's why they currently sat down there in ninth. But Mischiefs, they've got to try and their best to get something out of this game if they want to give themselves an easier ride in the playoffs. So here we go, game at number one underway. It's a four-game series. Will Shrine bring the gleam, the glisten to the game? Or will Mischiefs cause them to sit back and lick their wounds, basically?
It's a really close chance right off the start here, and they come out pretty hot. But what we have to remember here, it's a long road. It's a four-game series, like you said. You got to be able to play all four games properly. Good rotations, strong 50s. Let's see if you can find a teammate on the counterattack and get a goal here. First 30 seconds goes by and we're still 0-0, but it's a big chance to open it up, and the open net is taken, and Whiskey does what he's supposed to do. He scores.
That is not how you want to start a potential upset. All three players on the Shrine team just pushing a little bit too hard. I know they're eager to try and prove their worth, but you know, early doors, when you're going up against a team that's sitting high and pretty and looking to push on, you just got to make sure you don't concede an easy goal, and that's exactly what they've done there. So not the best to start, but Mischiefs nonetheless will be loving that one, and be wanting to try and capitalize and push the goal count even further up the scale.
Yeah, so we got to maybe mention the battle buses here that are out there, strong and true. I don't want to make it too much of a thing here, but this looks like it's going to be another goal, and that battle bus is looking more like the short bus there. It was not doing everything it needed to do. That was a poor clearance from Sim. I know he's better than that. He's going to hang his head down low, but they're going to regroup here, and they got to keep it close before anything gets too crazy.
Do indeed. Two goals in just over a minute played. Not the best start, but like you said, plenty left to play for. So kickoff is underway. B-Shake's in the midfield trying to get the quick shot on target, but that's eager enough for Pogo to send it into the corner. Gets demoed for his dues, and maybe that's what we want to see a bit more from the Shrine boys. Just with a bit more aggression and just try to unsettle Mischiefs a little bit. At the moment, it's not really worked out for them as the ball getting a bit caught up in the corner. Going to fall nice in front of B-Shake, but gets beaten to the punch by Pogo, bringing it up on right-hand side. Mischiefs got to be careful. Awkward touch into the middle. And Oliver trying to get the shot, didn't quite get on the end of it. And they can breathe a sigh of relief on that counter-attack.
Yes, they can. And it is actually starting to pick up a pace of play here. We might have a game on our hands if they can just find a nice bounce, maybe a lucky goal here. There's one. It's going to be off the backboard. Is there anyone there to finish? There could be. It's off the post. We have a 2-1 game. Don't go anywhere, folks. This could get a little bit dicey.
Wanted the lucky bounce. You got one there off the corner. Fell into the path of Mr. Ball. Didn't quite get his shot down, but it hit the backboard into the path of B-Shake. He slams it into the back of the net. So just when you thought Mr. Fool might be running away with this one, Shrine step up and say, don't even think about it. We're here to play. Sim now midfield, trying to get a pass infield. Didn't quite find either of his teammates. And Whiskey, slightly awkward in the air there. Falling nice in path now. B-Shake trying to get a flick onto target. Mr. Fool.
Speed going there, that's something that high level players all struggle to do. The higher level players depend on it. Really well done. Here comes Sim, gonna be up and over and down. Oliver having a little bit of a miscommunication with Pogo, but they still get the ball out. Not as a lot of boost here to work with. He gets it back down for B-Shake. He does well to push that ball back into the midfield. Sim's on a good rotation back. I have to say, Sky, they do look like they're competing.
Yeah, indeed. It was maybe sort of not quite firing all cylinders at the start there. Lovely save on the line by B-Shake. Nice shot from Pogo. Didn't quite have the power behind it. But yeah, maybe just the opening section, they just weren't... I don't know whether they warmed up before this or not, but it didn't seem like it. So they finally found their rhythm. Built, creating a bit more of a game on our hands here, and still very much in this one. But Mr. Ball, after having that goal scored against them, have kind of locked it down a little bit more on the defense and just testing... Testing on occasion the Shrine defense, and that hasn't quite worked out for them. Here comes B-Shake now into the midfield. Sim trying to get on in that one, couldn't quite get the read on it. And the demo from Mr. Ball and Pogo just didn't quite open it enough for Shrine. And here they come now, left-hand side. Awkward bounce off the corner, but that's fallen nice in. Bogger gets the read, pops it up for Whiskey. Shot on target off the crossbar. Oh. B-shake does just enough to take it away.
Well, that's as close as they've come since their first two goals there. It looked good. A couple of demos opened up the field there. Really good stuff, but bend don't break. Mistful's doing well here in the corner. They do lose boost possession there. Sim's got enough to work with. Oh, another great play by Sim. Let's see if they can get one more. He can't, but that might be allow them to clear their lines. This is going to be awkward. B-Shake has to do well, and he does.
At the moment, Mischief's doing well. They know that they've got the one goal advantage and they're not pushing hard. They're happy to just sit back a little bit and just keep that goal advantage. Oh, no. But it's not happening. It's lovely shot from downtown there. Missed the ball, wins the ball for B-Shake, who punts it forward, and Whiskey just caught flat-footed. Nothing he could do with that one. Tried his best, but it's ended up in the back of the net, and maybe that case of sitting back and just hoping that one goal advantage pays off has not quite worked out as well as Mischief would have hoped.
Now they're just trying to stay in the game here. It's 2-2, and there's 20 seconds left, and they've got some opportunities here. Here comes Sim to seal the bump. Oh, the puck gets back. That was so close. If there was any more power on that, it could have been, but now they got a counterattack with 10 seconds left. It's 15 in the middle. It's up. It's... saved! It's a It's 3 seconds left. Sky, I can't believe it. Oh my goodness, what a moment.
We both held our breaths there. Whiskey and Pogo went off. Pogo saw Whiskey at the better angle and thought, you have this one. And he gets the 50 in the air. Ends up in the back in there. 3 seconds on the clock. Mistful gets the better of the kickoff there, but it's not enough. And Mischief, oh my word, what a way to finish the first game. And fair play to Shrine. You know, they got off to a poor start, brought themselves back into that one, and you maybe got to feel that they perhaps deserve to take away that first game, but it's falling into the winner bracket of Mischief for that one.
Yeah, that's what it is. Those first minute of play in Rocket League can be so important. A lot of players take a little bit of time to get into the rhythm of the game, and that's when you can really steal some goals. The first 30 seconds, they escaped, but then a couple of mistakes, they're down 2-0, but the rest of the game, they played really well. They were really in that game. They very well could win the next couple here.
Yeah, and the thing is, they just got to get off to a better start. I think that just put them too much on the back foot. And in these sort of games, that first goal was always important. And you saw there, it just was too much of a struggle at the start there for them to find their rhythm. When they did, though, like you say, they brought themselves into it and definitely made a game of this one. B-Shake just carrying the team a little bit there with 3 saves and 2 goals. And maybe Sim and Mistyville can step up, add a few more points on the board. But nevertheless, first game done and dusted. Mischief will be liking the fact they've got that win on the board, which just edges them out a little bit closer towards the top of the table, but they got to make sure they keep that defense solid in this next game.
I think that's exactly what the boys will be saying in the chat there. Hey, we're good. Let's just calm down and win the next couple here. One game at a time, but the first 30 seconds is so important here. We're going to see what they can do. Hopefully they can escape at least 0-0 here. Maybe even a goal. It's a good start by Whiskey. It's going to be touched. It's going to be an easy chance here. It's going to be in. Oh, it hurts. It hurts, Sky. It hurts. You know it's coming. The first 20 seconds, 30 seconds, so important to stay off the board. And here they are, down 1-0 again.
It's almost a rinse and repeat from the first game there. Sim probably got a little bit off put, thought that maybe Oliver was going to hit that one, and completely miscued his third man defense on that one. But again, we see Mischief taking the first goal of the game. And whether they can capitalize on it like they did previously, we will see. Keeping the ball away at the moment is Shrine. So off Whiskey, awkward touch, plays it into the midfield, and Oliver sends it in the corner just to try and take some of that pressure off. That's a nice touch by Sim. Didn't quite work out for B-Shake, who rotates out. Missed the ball, keeping the ball alive. Into the path of Sim now. Gets the better of the 50 there, but met by Pogo. Takes it to the air. A Sky double commit there. B-Shake and missed the ball. Got to watch out for that and just settle down a little bit.
Yeah, and I just got to mention this. Wow, that was a close chance. Really risky play in front, but it's almost what he had to do. Didn't have much other option, but I just love this map. It's just beautiful, I have to say that. Another good play in front post. Takes one for the team as he gets demoed. They do have a counterattack available here if he can come join. Oh, he just takes it off his teammate there, Sky. So close, but they have an opportunity here. Another demo in front of the net. Another bump. Sim comes in. It's gonna be an awkward ball. They do have a boost advantage. Here it is. Save.
I'll go on the line. Saw the incoming danger and just knew he just had to hold the line, hold the door closed, and worked out for him. And they got him braced back on defense now as Mischief's looking to double the lead. And miscommunication again coming in from Shrine. Seeing a few moments of that when they don't quite look like they're on the same page. And Whiskey not able to get on the end of that one. Dangerously across the open net there, but Shrine somehow get away with that one.
Somehow, and it seems to me like the longer this game goes on, the more that Mischief are looking to be in trouble. They do not finish games well. Well, I guess they did technically finish the last game well, but they did lose that 2-0 lead for a bit there. They are starting to bring on the pressure. That's another big save by B-Shake. Here comes Sim. He does get a good touch. Only over to Mystical. Back into the mix. Here they come. It could be. Good save. Another good save. Sky, they are looking very solid at the back end here. They are rotating much better this game, Mischief is. And I don't know if it's going to be as easy to score on them this game as it was last.
See B-Shake off the corner there, trying his best to get the ball just in a nice spot for his teammates, but it hasn't worked out for him. Bit of a back and forth between two teams at the moment, it seems, as the ball gets stuck in the corner. 50 by B-Shake into the path of Sim, shot on target, and Oliver! Just enough to send it into the corner. Nice opportunity coming in for Shrine, but they've got to work their way back onto defense now as Oliver in the corner didn't quite work out for him. And this is honestly end-to-end stuff at the moment. Both teams trying their best to find a glorious opportunity and not quite able to get that finishing touch that they both so desperately want.
Oh,
just under 2 minutes left to play. Pogo, second goal nearly, not quite. This could go one way. Is in the back of the net. Whiskey with a second goal for Mischiefs.
Just about 10 seconds before this play happens, there's a great fake in the midfield, and he just kind of releases all the pressure there. Whiskey does to go left instead of go right, and that really does create the goal. Great play.
Indeed. So two goals down, and Shrine have got to work themselves back into this one. They've got less time now in this second game, but B-Shake into the middle, trying to get it past Oliver, but Oliver standing firm as a third man there. Ball still in the half though. Sim punts it back into the midfield. B-Shake, nice touch forward, back to Sim. Bit of 1-2 action between the Shrine boys here. B-Shake just let the ball run away from him, not able to get in on the end of that one. And good speed there from Oliver to just try and take some of that pressure off Mischief at the moment. They got two goal advantage, might have three on the board here. They do indeed, as Pogo sends it into the back of the net with a slight assist, you might say, from I think it was from Sim in the end. Not much. No, it's Mistiful.
Sim's all over that.
Yeah, if anything, Mistiful should have left that one, and Sim might have had that into the corner.
Yeah.
But three goals down, just over a minute left. I think we might see game at number two going into the favour of Mischief, and that'll be another victory that just edges them up even further up the board. But I've been wrong before. Three goals, 1 minute left. You never know.
Well, you never know, but it is tough when you start hearing the bells like this with a minute left. Maybe they could create some momentum for the next game. Oh my goodness, what a pass that is. Oliver says thank you very much, and he cleans up the rest of that. But look at this, guys, take another touch. Oh, he lets it. Oh, that's high level, Sky. He lets the ball come a bit further close to him and then just kind of allows it to direct back into the middle of the field. He's not trying to score there. He's trying to set up his teammate. That's really well done.
Indeed. And Mischief and Mischief even are playing a nice second game here. They're not doing anything too crazy. They're doing just enough as an opportunity coming in for Shrine. Didn't work out for them. But it seems they're definitely more calm and collected. Mischief team in this second game here, and four goals to the good. They can keep their clean sheet as well. You've got to feel that maybe there might be an opportunity here that they could go on and get the full clean sweep against the Shrine boys, which I'd hate that to happen because we never like casting a 4-0, but I'm sure Shrine will, like you say, just want to just maybe brush this one aside, come back in the third game and just not get off to such a shaky start, which seems to be their downfall at the moment in this series.
It is, and they didn't add insult to injury there. Maybe they could have, but it's tough to lose a first game the way they lost it, first of all. And to go into the second game and then get a bit outclassed, a bit outsped, a bit outrotated, they are going to have to come back with something pretty if it's going to be any points on the board for them tonight.
Yeah, I mean, look, we said at the start, they've got nothing to lose, nothing to win in this series now. It's pretty much done and dusted for their regular season. So this is just going to be an opportunity for them just to maybe put a slight spanner in the works for the Mischief Boys. They've still got that chance, but they're going to have to work just a little bit harder in games 3 and 4 here if they're to get some points on the board and just make sure Mischiefs don't run away with it one. But, you know, fair play to Mischief. I said, you know, that second game there, they looked very calm and collected. There wasn't the sort of panicking or the sort of double commits that we're seeing from the Shrine lads. And it just goes to show you, you know, maybe that's why Shrine are sitting at the bottom of the table, whereas Mischief are edging towards the top. It's just that team chemistry and communication at the end of the day for me.
It is. And I wish we could be a little fly on the wall for those comms, because I bet they are... I bet they're talking and they're up 4-0 and they're keeping themselves brisk, because the worst thing that you can do is let off the gas pedal. As we talk about that, they're all about to press theirs down as the countdown begins. And let's see if they can keep this momentum going.
Indeed, and we move on to probably one of my favorite maps, is old Sovereign Heights. Just a simple yet beautiful map. I'd probably say this, I don't know about you, Wynn, but this would probably be my... I prefer this one over Forbidden Temple. Both beautiful maps, but definitely one of my favorites here at Sovereign Heights. But early doors, and Shrine managed not to concede an early game here, which is a good sign.
It is a good sign. I'll take you up on that offer on this map being one of the better ones. This is a chance, though. This is where I do all my 1v1s, this map right here. There's something about it, isn't there? Kind of like a schoolyard map. I love it. Woo, huge demo. On the backside, here comes the counterattack. They got to be up. They aren't. Pogo's going for the double. Misses that. No one else is there. It's going to get put around the wall. But another big demo. Those demos just open up so much space for you. Here comes B-Shake. Gets a touch in the middle. No bump. But here's Sim. And they are out of the battle buses now.
The battle bus is just such a... Every time I see it, it just looks... I mean, it's not on the field anymore, but I don't think. But, you know... I'm kind of glad it's not on there, because it's just such an awkward thing to look at. But yeah,
does it have a heartbeat, or like, is there like a music playing in the battle bus? I just thought I could hear my own heartbeat for a second. I'm like, wow, I'm not feeling too hot. But did the battle bus do that?
I don't know. It's got a weird. I think just generally, it's just got a weird vibe about it. So maybe it just makes you sort of feel things that you probably don't necessarily want to feel. We're getting slightly sidetracked here, but...
Yeah, that's my bad. My bad. You keep me on. I'll Google that later. Not a problem. We have a chance here. The reset's on. Oh, that's special. Oh. We came back just in time, didn't we, Sky?
We did. Finally focus up when we get a beautiful double tap there from Oliver. Oh, just sublime. That's what you like to see. It seemed like the match had sort of petered out a little bit and not much going on, but Oliver had other ideas. He just biding his time to get a bit of a clip of the week potential in the back room there. So make sure you clip that one and submit it.
Yeah,
but yeah, want to see a bit more of that, and maybe a bit more from Shrine as well. Just even things up a little bit. Lovely passing field, but Pogo, good speed from him, beating Shrine to the punch. Here he is now, right hand side, shot on target. Oh, and Oliver, stop it, son. Absolutely dirty. Dirty challenge there off Mr. Ball. Gets the... I don't know whether that would be fortunate. He'll say it was calculated, but it's in the back of the net, and Shrine are 2-0 down.
Yeah, that was something special by Oliver there. I think it's calculated. He knows exactly what he's doing. He's trying to keep that ball in front of him, and he gets a really good position on that. Love to see that.
Third hit! Dangerous across the net, and Mr. Ball... this time taking it away, but only as far as Pogo, who gets straight back onto that one. Here comes Oliver now, up the midfield, shot on target, can't keep it down. Spoons over the net, it's above for Pogo, off the crossbar! And the net of Shrine is rattling at the moment. Fortunately for them, it's not ended up in the back of the net, so they've still got a chance. Shot into Sim, into the path of B-Shake, can't keep his shot down. And a couple of opportunities coming in for Shrine, but not able to convert.
That's as close as they've come this game, and it looked good, and they have another chance here, but Pogo says no! And you know what? He's made a couple of saves here. He's probably asking the lads, what's going on? Can we clear this ball? I'm a little out of saves. And they do, finally. They get it all the way over half, and they collect some boost. They can recollect themselves for another wave of attack coming again. Another good save by Oliver, who's having quite the game here.
Indeed, definitely popping off. Some people in chat are talking about at the moment. It's definitely showing his potential here going into the playoffs and making sure that we keep an eye of him going forward. But missed the ball, shot on target. Wow. Oh, nearly getting the top bins, but wrong side of the post on that occasion. And here's that man, Oliver, driving it forward. Nearly getting it past, missed the ball, but just wasn't quite sure whether to go for bump or take it around him. In the end, it's just... nothing's happened basically, but here it is.
Wow.
Third goal on the board, this time into it's the pocket of whiskey.
It's pretty. Take a look at it here. Oh, he just kills it. He just dies the ball, and he just a little change up. Those are tough to deal with. You can overcommit on them very easily. Really well done.
So no goals yet for Shrine. They've got just over a minute to just try and find that one elusive goal that you never know what might do. You know, the series is pretty much done and dusted for them, but this is all about pride now for Shrine, just to make sure that going forward, they might have a chance here. BJ going for the demo, lovely play there, but neither of his teammates quick enough to react to that one on that occasion. Ball gets sent straight back into the half. Lovely little pinch. I love a pinch every now and then.
I do. I do. I haven't seen a fake yet, and I know they're hard to pull off in threes, but would that just make me the happiest commentator in the booth? Absolutely.
Well, I think going into game number four, we want to see more of that action. Pogo trying to get in, but hits it the post. And nearly the icing on the cake for mischief there. Not quite on that occasion. Yeah, a few more fakes. I mean, I've got to give Shrine credit. They've been very aggressive, and I know that sort of B-shake style. As Sim, awkward miss there, and it's in the back of the net from Pogo. Probably the easiest goal that they've got so far this series. There's a slight misread off the sidewall there by Sim. Didn't quite get it. Falls nicely to Pogo. But yeah, I mean, Shrine, they've been aggressive, you know, getting in plenty of bumps, quite a few demos on the board across the entire team. I mean, that's seven demos to just one demo for Mischief. It just kind of goes to show you that, you know, aggression is good, but you just got to try and use it a bit more and take advantage of the space where it comes. But on this occasion, they've not even able to get the ball in the back of the net, unfortunately.
That's two games in a row. Yeah, you got to be feeling for them here. It's turned into a team that has something to play for, showed up. And that does happen sometimes. And it was always going to be a tough matchup for them on paper. But they are going to be looking to salvage something here. And to make us right in the booth, I would love to see them get one win.
I was going to say, you took the words out of my mouth. This is no longer about pride. Uh-huh. This is no longer about table position. This is all about making sure that both myself and Winalot's predictions come true. And there is still that chance. Shrine, though, have got to get that win. They've got to try and find something deep down to get that win. I mean, you can't take... We're not taking it away from Mischief. You've had to play an absolute blinder. But come on, this is for me and Winalot now. Yeah, we need to get our prediction.
Yeah, we know they're listening. We'll be interested to see if the battle bus has come out. I think their best games were actually from the battle bus. So we'll really listen for that heartbeat this time, and we'll see if we can make it a true thing or I'm crazy. So we're going to work out that. And as they do, this is another beautiful map. Definitely a top five for me. We are going to have a countdown, and we are going to have a final match to see if they can get on the board.
Going in, B Shake squaring off, loses out on the kickoff. Now Oliver, right hand side, pops it into the corner. All three of the Shrine lads are chasing that one. Bit of chaos early doors there, but they've somehow managed to work it out of their own half. B Shake now trying to get on the end of that one. Oliver takes it away from him. Sim from absolutely nowhere, missed the ball, gets beaten to the punch and not able to send it into the back of the net. So chaotic start at both ends of the field. Still 0-0, missed the ball. Another miss coming in from Sim. Not quite focused on all cylinders, it seems, on this series, as there have been a few missed opportunities. B-Shake, just... What just what happened there? Please save me the touch. Oh, I think that just, I would chalk that one up just to the team chemistry just not being on fire, as I'm pretty sure B-Shape left that one for Mr. Ball, who it seemed like was going back for boost instead. And it just goes to show you know, the difference between these two teams at the moment. Mischief really calm and collected, not too many mistakes, and Shrine just not working that well together.
Yeah, I think it's worth noting how, like, a fine oiled machine Mischief is playing together right now. They do look very, very confident on the ball, confident with each other getting hits. So it's good to see, and they might be able to make a run in the playoffs here.
Indeed, but they've still got one game to win, and I'll have a look at the table shortly to see what this might do for them in terms of where they finish second or third. It's definitely going to push them up, but as to where they will finish, we will soon find out. But they've still got 3.5 minutes left to play in this game here, and to try and keep Shrine at bay. They've given themselves a one goal advantage here. Oliver pushing it forward, but it's falling now into Sim, taking up on the wall, left hand side. What can you do with this one in the battle bus? Off the ceiling, trying to get some sort of touch.
Oh, wow.
Oh my word, nearly ending up, fortunately, at the back of the net, but the post comes to the aid of Mischief.
He is coming around here. Nah, we haven't seen Oliver take over this game as much as the last ones. I wonder if they're going to try to get him more touches. He's been so effective. But here they come, flying V. It's going to be on net. It's a great save by Pogo. Great save. Cleared all the way right back around to himself. He gets another touch. Sim back hooked by accident. We've all been there. And this is going to be back over. Pogo's going to be able to push this back in the middle. B-Shake can't get anything. There's a big demo in the backfield. Oh, great play by B-Shake. And the counterattack is on. They've got numbers. They just need to figure out who's going for the ball. They haven't figured that out yet.
Give
Here comes
time.
The counterattack the other way. Maybe next season. maybe next season. They're, oh my goodness, what a play! What a save! But it's up! A chance!
Oh,
it's up!
It's finally there! Finally, somehow, worked together as a unit. I mean, I wasn't quite sure at any point who was chasing the ball or who was doing what. But through luck or judgment, who knows, that one's ended up in the back of the net. And Shrine have tied it up as we hit the halfway point.
And this is turning out to be a great last game. I actually am a little bit excited to see if they can get a win on the board here. They're playing so well at the battle buses, it's almost a shame they didn't keep them.
yeah, and I mean, I've just noticed Mr. Ball's car. It's absolutely hideous, but it's working out for him as he's, maybe they're just going for the distraction method now. You know, they've tried everything else in the series, and now they're just trying to off-put Mischief by just absolutely blinding them with pure ugliness. Who knows? I don't know.
Well, but, I don't know. Would that work on you, Sky?
All the time. I mean, as a commentator, it's getting me distracted from what's going on the field at the moment. The fact that I'm talking about Mr. Ball, what a flick!
What? Where did that flick come from?
It's the car. It's over two of them as well. Yeah.
It was a very clanky flick. It looked like it hit three different parts of the hitbox, but it gets over, and we have a 2-1 lead.
And you know what? More importantly, though, like, Win-A-Lot, this means that our prediction, as it stands, is coming true. So, I mean, you know, well played, Mischief, but at the moment, I am going for Shrine. They are going.
Oh, we live to fight another day here, Sky. As it moves forward, Sim takes a touch. He gets it under control. He gets a little pool shot from his teammate. I don't know if he liked that or not. Good save by B-Shake. A needed save, but maybe an expected one. As he gets back down, it's going to be awkward. They must be able to have numbers here. You have the demo. Mystical gets up. No boost.
Oh, no. They triple commit.
Mystical has to touch there. He does. That's really well done, Sky.
The Pogo now into the midfield. It's off of Whiskey. Can't quite get the shot on target. Pogo with a follow-up. Oliver slams it in. Bottom right-hand corner. They took three attempts to try and get it in. And Oliver, he's had a bit of a quiet one in this fourth one. But he's finally stepped up and he's tied the game up as we've just gone. We've just under a minute left to play. So come on, Shrine. Don't let us down now. Find that third goal. Bring yourselves back into this one and make sure we get our predictions right.
Here comes Mistful. Great save by Pogo. Could be Pogo. Not positive.
tomato is one of those occasions. Yeah. As it hits the post. Mr. Ball keeping it alive. Ooh. But Pogo gets it away, left hand side. Gets it past B-Shake now. Mr. Ball cleaning up as the third man pops it into the mid. Here he comes now, trying to work some magic up the infield. Didn't quite get it on that occasion. Awkwardly across the net, and none of the Shrine lads realised what was going to happen there. And Paul's gone straight back into our own half as Sim flying in from the right left-hand side. He's just all over the place, and the ball rolls, rolling into Mama Whiskey.
Oh,
Sim!
Oh my goodness.
Keeping it alive, and we could see here, game four overtime, and this is it. This is it. Win a lot.
No way.
This is our predictions on the line.
It is. It all comes down to one. And they're off.
Vicky Shake squaring up against Whiskey. Whiskey gets the better of that kickoff there, but it's falling nicely to Mr. Oliver, though. Good speed from him. It's a Pogo. Can't get the shot on target. And Shrine somehow survive on that occasion. And I don't know. This one has the hallmarks of Shrine coming away with some beautiful opportunity. I'm predicting a double tap off the backboard here, but as for which player it is, don't know yet.
I'm gonna take Mistiful. I don't know, something about him right now.
It's the car.
It's the car. It is the car. I can feel my heartbeat again. Something's gonna happen. It's awkward. What a save from Polo, the near post, and here he goes. He's got really good distance off that. Oliver intercepts, and they counter. Pogo's gonna go up the wall here. He gets their first, he gets their second. All right, they are gonna get boost. They don't get boost.
They don't want it, they don't need
it. Nope.
Bit of a midfield battle going on between
here
two.
Here they go.
Now Mr. Fool, only got Pogo to beat. Trying to get the flick, and not on that kick.
He shakes out.
Can't keep the shot down,
but
it's very much alive. The man of the series, Oliver, coming in clutch there for Mischiefs at the end. Over a minute now. Sim shot, trying to get the shot target. Pogo, good rotation there. Gets the save on the line. This is good pressure at the moment from Shrine, but can they make it count? They've just got to find that opportunity. That one moment, Oliver, though. Breathing a sigh of relief, but Sim from downtown didn't quite get the read. B-Shape with a follow-up. My word, good pressure, but this one, you got to feel they got to make something happen soon. Otherwise, I can see Mischief going up the other end and just getting them on the counter.
That's how it works, doesn't it? You can't miss too many shots at one end without getting burned. They have a chance here. They just have to calm themselves down and make a good play. They're one good 50 away here from taking this last game. Oh, what a save that is.
Beautiful save by Mischief. Mr. Ball on that one. Oliver, no! No, Oliver, why would you do that to us? Why would you decide to turn and get the shot on target? How dare you ruin our predictions? Oliver, you've played an absolute blinder of a series, but the one time we wanted you to miss and do a mistake, you decide to just carry on doing what you've been doing all series and hit the ball in the back of the net. How dare you? But, I mean, fair play. Let's be serious for a moment. Mischief played a brilliant series, calm and collected throughout, and they got the clean sweep, win a lot. Oh, I'm annoyed.
I'm a little bit hurt. I don't know when I'll get over this, but when I do, I'll let you know. And we are going to have to recollect ourselves for the next one, but talking about this one, it's hard to even pick an MVP with how much of a team they were playing as. Mischief, they look so good through and through, but what a great display for them, and I hope they have a good long run in the playoffs.
Yeah, indeed we will. I was going to try and sort of calculate where exactly they will finish in the table, but my database has absolutely just decided to fail on me as I look over to it. I can't quite tell what's going on with it, so I'm not entirely sure where that's going to put Mischief in terms of table position, but certainly they will put, I think they're going up to third, potentially second with a clean sweep as well. I think it all just depends on the teams above them, but we will see. Nevertheless, though, well played, Mischief. Be keeping an eye out on them for the playoffs, because a team that like them, who throughout were just calm and collected, didn't make too many mistakes. They would, you know, good rotations, good bases, good fundamentals. Yeah. That is a good, solid team going forward into the playoffs.
Yeah, if you're watching that game, you're definitely looking at them being like, we are going to have to play tight if we're going to play them.
But that being said, it is easier to look good against teams that you are better than and faster than. So it's a couple of pandemonium on the goal line moments for them later in that game. Created some entertainment for us that last overtime. I was actually kind of on the edge of my seat there.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it just goes to show you just what sort of, you know, this is where the best Rocket League happens. Forget the professional circuit. We don't need that. This is where it all happens. And, you know, it doesn't matter what where your bats are on the table. There are players here that can give us some absolutely entertaining Rocket League. And we still got more.
get a good feeling. Yeah. Get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. Get a good feeling.
I've been thinking, I want you to be happier. I want you to be happier. When the morning comes and we see what we've become, in the cold light of day we're a flame in the wind, not the fire that we begun. Every argument, every word we can't take back, 'cause with all that has happened, I think now we both know the way that the story ends. Then only for a minute, I want to change my mind, 'cause this just don't feel right to me. I wanna raise your spirits, I want to see you smile. Well, it's eating me up inside, but we ran our course, we pretended we're okay. Now if we jump together, at least we can swim far away from the wreck we made. Then only for a minute, I want to change my mind, 'cause this just don't feel right to me. I wanna raise your spirits, I want to see you smile. I've been thinking, I want you to be happier. I want you to be happier. Even though I might not like this, I think that you'll be happier. I want you to be happier. Go!
Welcome back, everyone. This is it. This is the third and final game of the night, and is also the final game of the regular season here for RSC 12. And to wrap it up, of course, I mean, it just had to be us to win a lot. We did the last series. We're back for this final one, and we're going to bring the hype. I think for this final game.
We have to. It's the final game of the season. We might even get a wave started in chat here today. I don't know. But the thing is, we have two teams out there that are still competitive. They've got their pride out there right off the bat, and they want to win, and we want to watch them compete.
We do indeed. And the two teams that we are speaking about are Mosaic and Tartarus. It's a bit of an awkward one, because before this game, Mosaic were basically going up against the bottom team, Dwarves. And they needed to win that one. They needed that one to get it in the bags to give them a shot of getting into the playoffs. But unfortunately, they lost. And they lost quite hard as well, 3-1. So this one here, the final game, it's not quite got, you know, the sauce that we wanted. But nevertheless, these two teams will be wanting to bring it to the RSC fan base, and they'll be wanting to prove, you know, that it's just one of those days. And they will have, you know, there's no pressure, I think, is what we've got to look at this. There's no pressure on either of these two teams. Tartarus have got it in the bag. They are in the playoffs. They are essentially playing for either the fifth or the sixth spot. And Mosaic have beat, but they're out of it. There's no chance of them getting into this one now. So they can just sit back, relax, and pop off on stream. This is what we want to see, basically.
Yeah, this is what we want. And I think it's what we're going to get. We do have the ability to see some pretty good plays. And that can be exciting. Some solo plays, some team plays, maybe some resets, maybe some fakes. And I cannot wait to get this one underway.
I can't even get my words out at the moment. It's been the end of a long week. And I've tried my best not to slur my words during the actual game there. As you know, I've already done that and got myself a fail of the week. So hopefully this isn't going to be a repeat of that. But as you see there, just looking at the tables before we get into this one, Mosaic sitting in seventh. I mean, that table's a little bit out of date because, like I said, they lost 3-1. And that means that they cannot, even if they were to get a clean sweep, make it into the sixth spots there. But so Tartarus, this is basically it for them. They got to try their best to make sure they get enough wins on the board that are better than Anubis. Just so they give themselves a little bit of an edge going forward into the playoffs next week. So we will see. And I mean, with that, in regards to that, then winning a lot, we'll get into the predictions. And what is it? I think we've gone for the same thing on this one. We're just in sync tonight. But what was it you've gone for?
I believe it's going to be 3-1. I may have forgotten here, but I think Tartarus.
Yeah, it's the same for me as well. Tartarus. Yeah. I mean, they've got something, you know. It's only minor, but they have got something to play for still. Like I said, they got to try and make sure they get more wins than Anubis do. So I think they'll be bringing this one quite hard to Mosaic. And it's going to be interesting to see whether Mosaic, after coming straight off the back of that defeat, whether they can just relax and just get over it and just play some Rocket League and just, you know, just have a bit of fun. Or whether they're going to be feeling a little bit deflated. Who knows? There is only one way to find out. And it means going over to Manfield. That says Beckwith Park. I mean, I'm sorry, Gendo, you failed on that front there, but that is not Beckwith Park. But nevertheless, we're over in the stadium, and I don't know whether you've got the stats as to how many fans we got in the stands tonight.
It's a sellout crowd of 394,000. We have an online crowd of 29,000 as well. The 50-50 draw is at 3.5 million. That's nationwide, and we are ready to go. Everyone's locked in. So are the players. The countdown's about to begin. I'm actually really ready, and I'm really excited for this one. I think we got to look out for Stones today. I think he's going to be bringing the thunder.
You're going to go for Stones. I'm going to go for Buckets there, because I did see he's got quite a few goals on the board, and almost immediately neither of our players that we were going for getting a shot on it was, I don't even know how you say that one. Beehive? Somebody in chat tell me how you say XBEHI. Just give me a I don't know what the phrase is. Just tell me how to say his name. I don't know how to say it. I'm going to call him X, potentially.
Can we try Jibby?
Jibby? Jibby. I like the idea of Jibby.
Like Shibby.
Gandhi. He's not Come on.
I can't say that. I refuse to say that. Until he confirms that, I will not be calling him that. But they have a good chance here as Descent 2? It's going to be... these are some tough names, but we're going to make our way here. As so is Stones as he gets the ball over to the left side. He actually likes to leave that going in the middle of the field. He does get the first 50, and the second one's going to have to be saved. Descent 2 does well. Got up and right back down. Here comes Limp Noodle. As he's, that one comes right straight down off. That's a tough read. Those are always exciting when they read like that, but no, the read wasn't there today. Gonna have full boost, a good chance at net here. It's gonna be quick. It's in.
Oh, deadly Dom getting the first goal of the game there. Lovely play from, it's essentially a solo play. Pops it up, gets the second touch and takes it straight past Stones. And not calling in Gandhi. Gets it past B High. Into the back of the net for the first goal of the game. Tataris on the board, and they will be happy with that one. They can breathe a slight sigh of relief, but we've still got plenty left to play for here. The ball goes into half of Beehive, takes it into the corner, takes it into the middle, trying to get a second touch, not quite on that occasion.
Very close, though. This bucket clears their lines. Looking to add to their lead. They do have a demo here. That's going to create some space. They do get boost control. It's going to be well 50'd out by Deadly. So he's put back into the middle. Here comes the counterattack. It's going to be strong. Bucket's trying to get the connection. Oh, Shimmy does well there. He's going to get back into the middle. Deadly Calm does a good. Another great touch. They are really countering well, keeping possession. You love to see that from a team, not just booming it down the field and hoping for the best.
Stones now in the midfield there. Pops it up. Let's it run away from him, and Limp Noodle, love the name and love it even more if he's getting in the back of the net, but not quite on that occasion. Keeping the ball alive, though. Pressure on Mosaic at the moment. Can they withstand that and make sure they don't let this game run away from them too soon in the series? Jibby, I like your saying, actually. I'm not calling him Gandhi, just purely because if anybody watches this, they won't have a clue who we're talking about. So we're going to call him Jibby from now on. And if he has any issue with that one, then you can send a message to the mods over at RSE. But my win!
Jibby scores.
It had to be him. Lovely play off the backboard there by Stones as well, just to get the touch to send it into the midfield. And Jibby stepping up, slamming it home, equals it up as we've just gone past a halfway point here between Mosaic and Tataris. And it was probably that was a little bit against the run of play, Winterlock.
Absolutely. Didn't actually even look like they had much to go with there. He found a lot of power off that shot after a weird angle. But here we are, 1-1, as Stones take the ball up the wall. Leaves it for his partner, Jibby, who doesn't elect to go for it. Maybe a miscommunication there. Sentu's got to get a touch here. He does. Back up and over. Push back into the middle. No one rotating strong enough there. Jibby gets 50 over the sidewall again. There's some light pressure here. They're having trouble clearing their own end. Another great save by Sentu. He fakes into the middle. Great little play there. Wasn't fooling Limp Noodle. So up and over again. Stones is playing well. He's playing smart. They run into each other in the mid. He's got a partner in the middle. Oh, great interception by Limp Noodle there. Shibby's going to be back and over around. Looking to get there early. He does it. It's off the back wall. Great backboard defense. That's going to be so important this game, Sky.
Indeed. I mean, it's one of these underrated mechanics that you see in the lower leagues. It's just making sure that your backboard is covered, because so many times you just see it bounce awkwardly off the back or off the ceiling. And if you haven't got your backboard covered, then you can just see somebody come flying in from the midfield to get a shot on target. But here comes Deadly Tom, not quite on target on that occasion. But good signs nonetheless for Tatar. He's looking to regain that one goal advantage they had early doors. Well, with a minute left on the clock, it seems like Mosaic are definitely, they've got their head in the games, and it doesn't look like that defeat from the previous series is affecting them too much, we say.
Well, we can't say that yet, but there's 50 seconds left. Almost a dunk. That was really close from Descent. I gotta say here, these guys are looking close. Do I dare say we might see our overtime early on in this series? That would be exciting.
Oh, Stones might have other ideas about that, but Limp Noodle coming to the rescue.
Oh!
Got a fan touch and a bit of a last or late game pressure coming in from Mosaic here. Trying to find the back of the net, but not on that occasion. Buckets gets the better of it. My end in the back of the net. How did Buckets end that one? Somebody tell me, what did he do?
Oh my goodness. It was like a ghost touch in the air down into the dribble, and then he got the double tap with the half turtle. I think that's correct.
Welcome to Prospect. That's all I can say. When anything can happen and nobody knows how it happened, that is what this is all about. And it's all what a save!
All right, I can't take over Sky Kid.
he's just, he refuses to let anybody else get on the score sheet. He says, no. We don't need another goal. Let's just keep it at two, just to make it a bit more of a competition. But yeah, I mean, my man Buckets, I shouted out, he was the one to look out for, and certainly came into it in the late stages of that game there. So but you know, Mosaic, they had their moments sort of mid game. They would definitely bring themselves back into that one. Better start from Tataris and a better finish, but Mosaic seems like they're still got themselves a chance. And I think essentially what they got to do now is, you know, just relax and just enjoy, and you know, enjoy just playing Rocket League, because at the end of the day, that's what we're all here to do, is to enjoy it and to get a few clips as well. So, you know, fingers crossed we might see a couple of double touches.
That one goal is right out of the top drawer there. He just kept with it. It looked like he was fighting it the whole time, but at the end, he won the battle, and that's the goal that seals it. Some crazy plays happening there. Maybe a little unprofessional with the giggles happening there, but it was just so funny watching Buckets come across the goal line and keep that one out after him doing the most spectacular goal I've seen today.
I'll tell you what, when it comes to Prospect, it's expected that there's going to be giggles. That's what it's all about, you know. You got players, you know, you got some really good players in Prospect, but you know, it's consistency which is the difference between Prospect players and Premier players. And at this sort of level, there are going to be some very inconsistent moments, and you just got to smile and laugh at it when it happens. But here we go then, Forbidden Temple, lovely map. One of your, absolutely. I think you said it was one of your favorites, yep. Wasn't it, Winlock?
Top two. It's that and between yours as well. So.
We will see if a Mosaic can regain the series and tie things up here. Second game underway, and early doors just riding a little bit of momentum here from Tataris. Getting in a potential opportunity. Noodle trying to squeeze it. Oh, might get it, but Jimmy! Jimmy from inside his own net sends it away.
So close there. Oh my goodness, what a play by Stones. No one there to finish, but there's a double commit. Can anybody put this back into the danger area? It's up. They do have boost to collect there. Well done. Danger's not quite over yet, though.
It's not. They're playing well now, Mosaic. They're trying to just work a little bit of space here, but unfortunately, their second man left that one. Wow. Buckets! Buckets with a cheeky little touch to take it past the flailing third man for Mosaic there. Ball gets sent straight up the other end of the field. One little touch, Decentu goes flying. Give that man a stretcher because he's going to need it to get himself back from the hospital. But Tataris again, getting the first goal of the game. But Mosaic, you know, they had a couple of opportunities, so they're still very much in it.
Yeah, can't count anyone out yet. However, that hurts. It makes it harder. It does make it harder. That's a great play by Limp Noodle to win there. And then they do collide on the backboard defense that really leaves it wide open for Deadly Dom.
Yeah, I know we were talking about, you know, backboard defense, but at the same time, you know, just that's one of you go up there. You don't need both of you up there at the same time. That's that just comes down to communication. But hopefully they'll learn from that one. Two goals now to find to bring themselves back into this series. But Tataris looking all right at the moment, putting in a good shift here. Buckets now a demo. Stones though saw the danger incoming and tried to clear his lines, but he's falling awkwardly across their goal line again. Pressure mounting here from Tataris, trying to find that third goal. Shot on target, Decento just, it almost seemed like it was going to float in the back of the net, but for him, he had it covered. But at the moment, Mosaic just needs to settle down a little bit.
They do, a couple of bumping each other, getting each other. They're getting in the way of their own rotations, which is tough. Wow, what a play, and what a save. Another great save. It's still there, though, for finishing. Another great save by Descent. Oh, my goodness. Danger's not over yet, though. Pandemonium on the goal line. Nobody knows what to do. They're all just hitting the ball. It gets up the wall, and we are out. Well done. Only to the half line here. Stones clears it. That was a bit of a chaos.
And this is how you can get yourself back into the game, making some saves and then going and get a goal at the other end.
And indeed, and I mean, no demos recorded on the board yet for the Centaurs. There may be a little bit more aggression. Sorry, for Mosaic. You know, a few more demos, a few more fun plays, just open it up a little bit and just go for it basically at this moment. You know, halfway point in the game, you need to find something and you need to make it happen. Otherwise, you just feel like Tartarus are just playing the motions at the moment. They're not too concerned about doing anything too fancy or too flashy. They're happy that their two goals are good. And at the moment, they're looking quite comfortable.
They are. There hasn't been too many breakdowns in defense, but here comes Stones. He's going to get a good hit. It's off the backboard. Can anybody finish? No. They triply come up onto that. Everybody did not. They all recognize the danger there, which is very good to see, but they are going to have to organize that back line, or there could be some problems coming in. That's a great play by Stones. Good read on that. Back in the middle. This is dangerous. Shippy's going to have to do something. He does. He gets the first touch there, Sky. Very important touch as well. They keep him in this game.
Jimmy playing a good game here in the second one, but he's on the losing team at the moment. Bucky's trying to find a third, and Stones this time racing out from his goal line. Now it falls in past as Jimmy taking it to the sky. Can he get a third touch off the crossbar? Descentu not able to get it past Buckets, who raced off to avoid that one, ended up in the back of net. Deadly Dom now taking his time. Saw Lip Noodle was coming in from the side to try and get the demo, but it's left Buckets alone at the back. He does a nice play, sends it into the corner, just takes off some of that pressure. Stones, though, equal to it. And at the moment, Mosaic, got to find something quickly and got to find it soon. Otherwise, I can see this one petering out into a victory here for Tartarus.
Yeah, if something's going to happen for him, it has to happen soon. Maybe it's starting, it's time to start throwing that third man a bit higher, see if they can clean up on a garbage goal or something like that. It doesn't matter if you lose 3-0 or 2-0. See what they can do.
Yeah, I mean, in Rocket League, I always find like this third, when this, you know, a third goal, whether it goes to the team losing or the team winning at this late stage, can have such a, can change the momentum of a game so much, just because it sort of puts the winning team on edge, or it sort of makes them relax a little bit. It can go either way, but as I'm talking, the clock's counting down. And 30 seconds left on the board, and at the moment, no clear-cut opportunity coming in from Mosaic and Tartarus. They've got it sealed, I think. They're not going to panic, and I'm not trying to say that just to cause a casting curse as well.
Yeah, well, surely they'd be okay here. Great play by Shibby, and it's going to be a great save by Buckets. Came from nowhere there, and he just said, I'm not done yet. And that's going to be a no, it's not. Deadly Dom makes a save. He makes the second one. 3 seconds left. Surely not enough time now, but maybe one for glory. No! Wow.
No, not able to get the consolation goal at the end there. But I feel like I should have said nothing was going to happen a bit sooner, because it seemed like as soon as I said that, they were just putting in the efforts on target. But Mosaic didn't get a goal on the board. And well played to Tartarus on that one. Just went through the motions and, you know, solid game from them. So game number three. Coming in for us next and win a lot. I mean, we saw it in the last series. We didn't quite get our predictions, but I don't know. Can you see us getting predictions correct for this series?
It's got to be 50-50, and we do. This might change some things. We do have Mosaic having a sub coming on for game 3 and 4. So they will be using a substitution. I don't know if that changes our predictions or not. I hope it keeps us true, but so far we're correct.
Yeah, I mean, a sub can do wonders, or it can play havoc. It just changes the rhythm of the game a little bit, and Tartarus seemed like they had the measure in Mosaic, so I think this is going to do going to play really well. And we've somehow yeah, you can't see it on the stream, but we've ended up in a map which was not on the rotation list, we say. We will just scratch that one up to a slight technical glitch. And players not happy about that one, that's for sure. That's all I can say. I mean,
it's too bad. That's my third favorite map.
Okay, if anybody in chat can guess what map has just caused absolute chaos, put your answers in chat and we'll tell you if you got that right or not as to
there's no way they guess. There is no way they guess what map we were just on. Not a chance.
I will say is probably one of the worst maps you can play normal regulation Rocket League 3s on, and I'm so glad, you know, we'll just sort of skim over that one.
Well, that was quick. Okay.
Was it? Yeah, it is Wastelands, isn't it? It's bad. Yeah, bad.
Or is it?
Yeah.
Bad? It is, right?
I'm pretty sure it's that. Yeah, Wastelands. It's a really big open map that basically is, you know.
It's just like a wasteland.
Yeah. It's absolute rubbish. Let's put it that way. Fortunately, we sorted out the technical issue and we're moving on to a much better map. We're moving on, of course, to Sovereign Heights for this next one. And yeah, it was Badlands. We kind of gave that one away.
Right, right.
Yeah. But we'll tell the players to go, and we'll just cut. Oh, never mind. We are waiting on players, and I've just told them to go. So hopefully they ignore me, which I think they probably will do, because nobody really pays attention to me anyway. And
yeah. No, they're waiting for the real one to say it. Here you go.
I tell you what, this just had to happen, didn't it, for the final series of Regulation Series. I mean, and as well, Kendo, I mean, trust me, I know you're trying to put in, you know, you're doing a fantastic job, but that is not Sovereign Heights as well. That is the wrong wrong map. So ignore that, everyone. This is just blame this one on the gremlins in the streaming side of things, yeah, behind the scenes.
Side note, though, do you know how much rent is in those Psionics buildings? It's insane. It is insane. Ooh. On this map, I tell you. You get free Rocket League to watch. I think they just include that in the rent. It's quite the spectacle. $6,000 a month. Can you believe that?
I wow. Okay, that's. I was going to say, is it more than like an apartment over in New York City? And that is... yeah, that's a lot higher than I was going to say. But I mean, you know, when you're watching great action like this RSC, I mean, I think that's money well spent at the end of the day, I reckon.
Yeah, I've been bidding on like 3 or 4. I keep getting declined. This Morris Sky guy keeps outbidding me. So you could just watch yourself. I need one of those high flying views. Are we leaving this match as well and setting up the, or are we just playing in this one?
Okay. I think we're still playing in this one. We're just waiting for two players, which seems like they have finally joined. I mean, this is not a technical issue. This is a player issue now. They are making us wait, and they're just trying to give us the hype and just trying to get things going. You know, they're building suspense, basically. Here we go, then. Game number 3. We can finally get it underway, Winnerlock. Finally.
Oh, I thought this day would never come. But here we are, and we are looking to be going perfect on this. We want 3-1, and I think we're going to get it this time. I think we're going to be right. There's no way we're wrong twice like that.
You might have just jinxed it there, but we will not see nonetheless. It's Deadly Tom. Beautiful save on the line there. Lovely passing play coming in early doors from Mosaic. But fortunately, Tataris breathe a sigh of relief as a lovely save from Deadly Tom. Here they come now, right hand side. Let's the ball run away into the midfield. Deadly Tom shot on target and just above. Can he get a follow up? He can indeed. And 30 seconds played, and Tataris 1-0 up.
Right where they want to be, back in the driver's seat.
Lovely play, lovely shot. And what? Do you like that goal explosion? I'm still undecided about it, Winnerlock.
Don't mind it. It's okay when it's on your team, and it sucks when someone scores against you with it. That's how I kind of feel about it.
There we go. Words of wisdom. Mm-hmm. I'll take that one.
Yeah. That's all for you.
Oh, back to the action. Here we go then. So one early goal for Tataris. Can they keep this pressure up? And they'll be looking to go for the clean sweep because they're going into the playoffs. They have their position that's cemented for the playoff season. They will be wanting to go in that with some confidence, so 4-0 will do them the world of good. But Mosaic will want to just, you know, put a little spanner in the works. It's a shot just wide of the post there. Lovely play off the side there, but didn't quite work out. Then Buckets keeping the ball alive. Pops it into the backboard. That's a nice backboard defense there by Shibby. But the second touch lets it run away into the path of Deadly Dom, and Stones has to clear up on this occasion. But not able to get out their own half at the moment, Mosaic.
No, they're just barely getting out. They did a good rotation. They kept the damage to a minimum. They do have chances here, but those balls into the middle, I think, need to stop happening for them. off the sidewall. It's just they're not winning that secondary touch, so I think they got to stop doing that if they're going to stay in this game.
Dom almost getting in another goal there, but fortunately for Mosaic, I'm starting to get packet loss and late is the variation. I don't know about anybody else in the game, but hopefully that's just me and my internet issues. We will see Deadly Dom now into the midfield. It's beaten to the punch by Stones and sends it straight back into Tataris's half. But just like that, no second man with the follow-up, and it's just ended straight back into the Mosaic half. Bit of back and forth, limp noodle, good. 50 from him, falls now neatly into the half of the buckets. Off to the backboard he goes, plays it into the ceiling and decides to completely take it away from limp noodle.
I think it was a six-man commit there. And it's in!
Oh. I mean, bizarre run of play. It just, you know, Tataris were looking to set things up and probably just took one too many touches, and just like that, a glorious opportunity comes in for Mosaic. Do well to send it to back of net, and as we hit just about to hit the halfway point, they tie things up.
Got another chance here. Just can get another touch. Oh, it gets demoed for his business. But here comes Shibby. He's up. Gets the reset, but it's pushed straight down. Uses the reset. Push the ball to the wing. Actually, pretty well done there. Here comes the counter again. They keep the ball pressured in. I'm just going to have to turn on this. He lets his teammate to go. Shibby gets around one. Trying to get around two. Gets it over. Oh, it's off the crossbar. It's free for goal. Can anybody be there? No, I cannot believe someone didn't follow that play up. Really well done by Shibby there.
Bit of ball watching going on and admiration for Shibby. Just taking it to the air. Beautiful, beautiful style. But yeah, you definitely need a second man coming in just to get that potential second opportunity. Here comes Buckets now, pops it into the midfield and trying to get into half of Limp Noodle. Gets it just a little bit too far away from him. Demo in the midfield there, and a bit of pressure now being applied from Tataris, but they've had the ball just to run away from him a little bit. Deadly Dom taking it to the air, tries to get it forward, but both Stones and the sub-legend, I'm just going to call him Legend Landry. Let's just call him Legend for the time being. Doing quite well for Mosaic as the sub.
Yeah, it seems like it'd be like a bit of a different game. I mean, the packet loss isn't easy for these guys, though. You can definitely see there was some packet loss. But it seems to have settled down now, so we're back on a regular schedule here.
So, minute on the clock to play. 1-1 is on the board. Who will come away with the third game at victory here? Mosaic are fighting for the caster's prediction. They need to get one on the board at least, and they might just have it as Stones comes charging in from the right-hand side there. Lovely touch from Legend, pops it awkwardly onto the ceiling and buckets. Not much he can do with that one, and Stones slam it into the ground, makes it an awkward save. And fortunately for Mosaic, they are now ahead for the first time in the series. They got 50 seconds to hold on.
They do, and those are so tough to save sometimes when they hit them down, but they go up. So tough. Great save by Shibby there. He's coming back down the field. This could seal it. The demo's on. He just has to get it on net. Oh, what a save. Oh. No one knows what to do with it. Oh, it goes back over to the side wall. Everyone waiting for an imitation on that one, but what a great play. Stones is up now. He's up and over. Where are these guys coming from?
Don't know, but Deadly Dom, another lovely save. Tataris have definitely been pegged back now. Mosaic are looking to get the icing on the cake, and Shibby, formerly known as Gandhi apparently, lovely play off the ceiling, gets the read on the ball, nothing buckets and Deadly Dom can do about that one, and send that one to Clip of the Week, because that was a beautiful play for Prospect.
That's really out of the top drawer. I know he came from the top drawer, but he really put that down on an angle. Really tough. Gets the reset underneath. Oh, great fake there. And it looks like, oh, what a save. It looks like they're going to hang on here for a game three win.
Where did this one come from Mosaic? They seem to just turn up the pace there in the second half of that game. They wanted to make sure they came away with a victory to round off the season and give us casters a chance of getting our predictions spot on. But we still got one game left to play, and I know Tataris will be itching to get the victory on the board there, because of course, you know, it going into the playoffs, I mean, we know Tataris are there, and they are battling essentially now for fifth or sixth spot. And when you get into the playoffs, that extra series that you play can sort of affect you sort of mentally, and whether, you know, physically, making you just that little bit more tired. It could be the, you know, the deciding factor between how far you make it in the playoffs.
Yeah, you only got so many good games in you. Anyone listening who's playing ranked, you win four or five games in a row, just go play casual for a bit. You've got your best games out of there. So tournaments fatigue is real. Playoff fatigue is real. You don't want to have to play those extra games if you don't have to. So a lot on the line here, and an amazing super sub comes in and plays an amazing third man back role. And it seemed like their defensive struggles were just figured out.
Yeah, I mean, it'd be interesting to know, you know, what just went on in that game they played, or that series they played before this against Dwarfs. I mean, Dwarfs were sat at the rock bottom of the table, and sort of on paper, you'd feel that Mosaic perhaps would have been more than easy enough to come away with victory in that one, but they didn't quite do it. And so this is why we found ourselves in this position, but they definitely turned up in that last game and given ourselves a chance to sort of see them just, you know, pop up, which indeed they did. And it was that man, Jibby. Lovely shot to see. And can he do it again here in game four?
Well, he's going to try. They start quick. That's actually a really good save. An amazing save. It actually keeps them alive in the first 30 seconds here. It's so hard to avoid that first 30-second goals off a kickoff. And they find themselves back in the midfield fighting for possession. And this might be a good little test. It could be. Oh, it's a three-man commit. They got to get back quick. And they do. Thank goodness there was no quick counterattack there, because that could have been a problem.
Just saw the flash of sort of opportunity in front of Mosaic. All three of them thinking, this is it. This is the chance to get a goal. And then you got to be careful. I mean, early game here, 0-0. Don't want to commit too hard like that too soon. Stones trying to bring it out of his own half. Does well enough in the 50 now. Leaves it into far for Jibby. Got to beat, get it past Deadly Dummy, bumps it out of the way, and it's falls nicely into Papa Buck. It's Deadly Dummy, the redirect, what a shot! What a pass, and what a shot!
Look at this. He just picks out his teammate there after he won the ball, and he puts it right on his head. And he says, not a problem, I'll put this on net from here. 65 miles an hour, over the 100 kilometer an hour mark. That is well hit.
Beautiful shot there. Love to see it, and we want to see more of that in this final game here. Can we see it? Indeed, we will see. I mean, Hussein, custom double flip reset incoming. I've yet to see even just one flip reset. So if I see a double flip reset, I will go absolutely mental. But we will see. Deadly Dom, lovely challenge. Just didn't quite get the shot down. Buckets with a follow-up. Nice save on the line there by Legend Landry, the super sub, who made all the difference there in that last game, is looking to turn it up again. Lovely touch into the path of Jibby. Oh, my word. Super sub indeed.
Look at this. Baits him in and pops it into the middle for his teammate. Doesn't get selfish. Lets him finish it off. And that's exactly what you want your super sub to be doing.
Do indeed. One all on the board, but still lots to play for here. Tataris got off to a good start, and they might get themselves a second one here. Stones pops it up into Papa Bucket, sends it into the back of the net. And just like that, Tataris regain their slim advantage, but awkward touch there from Stones. Not much he can really do about that.
Oh, yeah, his hands are tied there, and looks like they're trying to help us be right.
You know what, I was getting so into the game, I completely forgot about
it.
Forgot,
you did, yeah.
Yeah, but no, yeah, you're absolutely right. They all might get up there. Not quite Jibby this time, turning into the saviour for Mosaic. And here he is now, left-hand side, trying to find a... What's it? Deadly Dom!
Oh, my goodness! Oh, how?
I don't know. I'm still trying... That was insane. Somebody clipped that one as well. That was reaction. Reaction goalkeeping at its finest there from Deadly Dom. And they can breathe a slight sigh of relief, but the pressure's still being applied by Mosaic here, keeping the ball into Tyrus's half and not able to find the finishing touch at one. But my word. Nearly cutting an equalizing goal there as he hit the halfway point.
Just agonizingly close as another really close chance goes beckoning across that goal line. You almost feel like this game's got a couple more goals in it.
Doing indeed. Stones doing anything now. Right hand side gets a good challenge on Buckets into Bava Jibby, but speed from Deadly Dom coming off That one sends it into the corner, into Papa Lim Noodle, sends it down past Stones, who just crept a little bit too far there at the far post. Found himself stranded in the middle of the net, and that's a lovely shot there from Limp Noodle. Did just enough to send it past Stones and just make sure that we've got ourselves a slightly more, you know, we can breathe a little bit more now. Winlock still just under 2 minutes left to play, and Isaiah are definitely turning up to try and spoil our fun. But yeah, what a game this is to finish the series off.
Yeah, so far it's been quite the banger, and there's been some really nice goals and some really nice defensive plays. I am a huge fan of the defensive plays in Rocket League. They win you games, but they do find themselves down 3-1 right now. It's a great play in the middle. If you could just get one more touch, nope, Limp Noodle's all over that. And here we go. Legend, the super sub, is up. He doesn't get the bump. Oh. Deadly Dom ends up with the save there. Good play, though, from Legend. He's showing really good promise.
Indeed, and I'm intrigued as to why he didn't start. Lovely save there from Stones. Sends off the backboard and just enough. Shibby now into the path of Legend Landry, trying to get a quick shot on target, but not enough power behind that one. Easy enough for Buckets to take it into the corner, but gets met there by Shibby now. Left hand side off the backboard. Lovely pass in field, but Legend can't get that one on target. And as I was trying to say, it'd be interesting to know why he didn't actually start, because he's definitely seemed to have made such a huge difference to the Mosaic team play. I mean, they are losing this game, but they're definitely putting a lot more efforts on target.
Yeah, I think they're actually a bit unfortunate to be in the losing section of this game. I just felt like it was a couple of mistakes they made and they got punished. But that's what good teams do. They take advantage.
Indeed, and looking to take advantage here to get a 4-1 on the target. Nice catch by Buckets, but just a little bit too far from him. And Legend Lamry trying to shoot on
there
target.
He is.
21 seconds to go. I'm not going to sing the song, but they've got given themselves a chance now to take this one into a fourth and final OT of the season. Lovely play there from Legend or Lanners. Lanners. I don't know why I didn't think of that one sooner, Orbean, but Lanners indeed stepping up. Here he is. Lovely challenge from him. Can he find a pass in field to teammate? Not quite.
Oh, someone's got to be committing with 15 seconds left there. That's just a lack of awareness. Great bump by Lannard. Uh-oh, this could be it. Oh, that 50 is just beautifully put in the corner.
1 second.
It's up.
Keep the ball alive.
And
not
it's down.
Quite. Oh.
Look at us, though.
Yeah, we know what we're talking about.
We did it. Yeah, we did it. Spot on.
Oh, I can only thank Mosaic for getting that victory there in the third game. That's made mine and Winalot's night all the more sweeter. But nonetheless, Tataris will be happy with that one, because that victory, unless I think Anubis get a 4-0 clean sweep in their final game, I'm not too sure when that game's being played, but they will see themselves into the fifth spot. And they will be happy with that one, because that's one less series that they potentially got left to play. That's not official, I don't know yet. But we will see nonetheless. But, you know, it was a good series. You know, it not much at stake, let's be honest. It wasn't like we were, had a potential playoff spot on the line, should we say. But nevertheless, win a lot. I thoroughly enjoyed that one for a final game, for a final series of regular season.
It's just a great little teaser for what we're going to get in these playoff rounds. And there isn't much more exciting gameplay than watching Rocket League knockout rounds, and it's just, there's something about it, it's very special. I've played a lot of high level sports, but there is something about Rocket League that is just very exciting when there's a tight game. It just feels like anything can happen.
Indeed it can, and no doubt, I'm gonna put it now, it will happen. There's gonna be some upsets,
absolutely.
There's gonna be some clips, there's gonna be some fails, it's gonna have it all. And if you want to find out more about that, then tune in tomorrow, of course, to the RSC Pass. That's going to give you all the information that you need to know going forward into the playoffs, and they will be, of course, putting their predictions and little teasers as to what to expect in the coming weeks across the different divisions. But for tonight, though, Winalot, it's been a pleasure. And before we disappear, I'm just going to quickly give a shout out to the sponsors, of course: Rule One, Brick and Brack, Synthesized Design, Panthera Esports, Gamers Beat Cancer, Gamers Apparel, and Badass Studios for supporting us throughout the season. It's been an absolute as always, just been a fantastic season.
Yeah, it was just lovely, and I know I wasn't there for most of it, but I was keeping tabs on it, and I really got to say, I am excited for the playoffs.
Indeed. So am I, and I don't know yet which ones I'm going to be casting, but we will see nonetheless. Anyway, that's enough waffle for tonight. Well played to all the teams across all three games, and of course, to Kendo in the background there for keeping the stream going. It's been an absolute pleasure, and before we disappear, any final thoughts from yourself, Winalot?
Hey, let's get ready to playoffs. I love it.
Couldn't have said it better myself. So on that note, you all enjoy your final hours here on a Sunday night, and have a great week coming up, and we'll see you back at some point in the not too distant future.
Let me hear you say that it'll be worth it.